إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا
Nasr al-Ansi, aged 39, before his ambitious claims today has trotted al-Qaeda's warped globe. He once fought in Bosnia, one biography says, and then bin Laden apparently took notice of his military prowess when al-Ansi attended camps in Afghanistan at the height of the group's haven there under the Taliban in 1998. Dispatching him to the Philippines to spread their toxic brand ahead of 9/11. But after that attack changed the world, he soon found himself detained back in his native Yemen, it's unclear why, for 6 months only. Afterwards, he seems to have devoted years to study at an Islamic university there. Perhaps it was Yemen's turmoil that drew him back to jihad in 2011, fast becoming a senior figure, mostly seen addressing the camera at length and here giving military lessons. In the last months, he's made three striking statements, some say to recast AQAP's image in the jihadi world, where rival jihadists ISIS have risen in notoriety. He first berated the savage beheadings familiar to ISIS.
The Prophet commanded us to benevolence in everything, even in killing. It is not from benevolence to record the way of killing or slaughtering and posting it for the people, so the sons of the killed see it, or his daughters or relatives. This is among the ugliest of matters.
Obama
made a decision that caused things to go in a completely different way than we wanted.
Luke Summers, I'm 33 years old. I was born in England.
Secondly, he scolded Barack Obama's bid to use special forces to rescue American hostage Luke Summers, saying they'd sought a different outcome. And at the close of last year, in al-Qaeda's Inspire magazine, he called lone wolf attackers, like the gunman who took over a Sydney cafe, the, quote, lions of Allah. Today's claim, a naked bid to associate the older brand of al-Qaeda with the newest horror Europe is reeling from. Nick Paton Walsh, CNN, Beirut.